Hi, Mike Redding here from usingtechnologybetter.com. In today's video, I want to show teachers how they can use the OneNote class notebook creator to create class notebooks in OneNote and then easily share them with their students. Now, teachers and students have been using OneNote to collect and organize information, but now it becomes really easy to create class notebooks and then share them with your students. So what we need to do is just click on the Settings tab in the top right-hand corner of your screen once you've logged into OneDrive, and then click on Site Content. Now, you'll notice here that the OneNote Class Notebook Creator app is just here on the page, and so we need to just load that. If your administrator hasn't loaded this onto your domain yet, and you need some help in knowing the best way to do that, then you can just watch the video, which is linked just below this video, to see how you can add this for your domain. So once the OneNote Class Notebook Creator app has been launched, we'll see that the next lot of options we have is to create our notebook. So from here, what we do is we click on Create a Class Notebook, and this is going to be the first one that we've created. So I'm just going to create a notebook called Demo Class, and then click Next. From here, you'll see that you have an overview of what your notebook will look like. And so you've got three different spaces for you and your students to interact. The first space is a collaboration space. And so this space is where your students and your teachers can work together. And you can see there that the teacher can edit the content, and so can the students. Now, if you want to call this something other than collaboration space, then just simply click on the rename link just here, and you can name it whatever you like. You'll see that the next one down is a content library, and this is basically a place for you as a teacher to add your content, but the students can only view it. And then you've got individual notebooks. So as a teacher, you can create a notebook for each one of your students, and they'll all show up on the same screen. Your students can't see each other's notebooks or collaborate or interact with those other notebooks, but as a teacher, you have view access and edit access to that whole stack of notebooks there. So once you've gone through and renamed those, the next step that we want to do is just add our students. Now, if you've got a list of students, you can just simply type their names or their email addresses. And just as you would normally expect, if you just start to type your students' names here, if you've got them in your contacts, then they will show up. So once you've typed in the students that you would like to add, then we just simply click Next, and it's going to create some space for us. Now, originally what we've got here is handouts and class notes, homework and quizzes. If you would like to change those, you can simply just untick each of these boxes and then add the ones that you would like to add. So it's completely customizable by you as a teacher. So once we've done that, we just simply click Next, and it's going to give us a preview of what that would look like. So here's the teacher's notebook, where you've got our class name up the top, and then we have our collaboration space, our content library, and then you can see underneath here that there are two of my students who are sitting there. Now, what I can also do here is have a look at what the student's notebook would look like. And so, for instance, the student has their collaboration space, their content library, and then they've got their own notebook, which has the three or four sections which are customizable by you as a teacher. Once we've done that, we're just going to click on Create, and then that's going to go away and create our workbooks for us. All right, fantastic. So it's all done and created. So once we've gone through that process, you'll notice that there is a box here that has a link to where this OneNote sits. You're going to need to give that to your students. So if that was me, what I would do is I would take that and I would run it through Bitly and create a unique URL, a short URL for your students to be able to type in or just be able to click on an email. Once you've done that, it's as simple as being able to enter in this URL address here and then access the OneNote. So once you've got your class notebook organized, if you ever want to add more students, you just simply click on the Add New Students, choose the notebook that you would like to enter, and then just continue to add your students' names in there. You can also, from this home screen just here, also view all your existing notebooks that you've created and shared with students, and they'll all just show up here in a list. If you have any questions, just simply leave a question or a comment in the comment section below this video, and we can continue the conversation there. If you'd like more helpful tips on how you can use technology better, then just head over to usingtechnologybetter.com, where you'll find lots of how-to tips and tricks, as well as lots of videos on how you can use technology better with your students.